And welcome back. Well, this is a video put together by the National Alopecia Areta Foundation about their annual conference. The common theme from all the attendees, they get to be around people who look just like them. This weekend, there are two very fun events to fund research for treatments and a cure, support awareness, and help children with alopecia attend this life-changing conference.
I love it. Here to tell us all about Morgan's Ride for Alopecia and Milwaukee Rock for Locks is Josh Lang, and we have here Ava Herbst. We're welcoming her back, and it's my understanding that your fifth grade class at Ronald Reagan Elementary School in New Berlin is watching right now.
Hi, everybody.
All right. Hi, guys, at Ronald Reagan Elementary. What do you want to say to your teacher?
Hello.
That's great. I'm so happy to see you. I was just asking you during the commercial break, how many times do you think you've been on the morning blend?
Three times?
Yeah,
this is my third.
So maybe first grade, second grade?
And then now.
And then we missed you third and fourth grade. I don't know how you...
And we miss you when you're not here.
Yeah. We're like, where is Ava? Now, who's the friend that you brought with you?
This is Eva.
Okay, pick her up.
So this is Eva,
yes. And you're Ava. And why is this your doll, or why is it that you brought her?
Just because, like, if people have, like, cancer or alopecia, they can, like, have their own doll, and it would be special to them.
And it'll look like them.
Yes.
Right? Beautiful, like
yes.
you.
Yeah.
I like that.
Let's talk a little bit about what alopecia is. Mm-hmm. Tell us, like your shirt says, what is alopecia?
Yeah, this is actually Charlie Villanueva, former Milwaukee Bucks player, has alopecia, and he kind of designed these t-shirts for
Very
awareness.
Cool.
But it's an autoimmune condition, so it affects about 2% of the population across the board, and then about 1% of that 2% has the version that Ava has, which is also what my daughter Kaya has, which is universalis, complete and total hair loss across the body.
For people who don't understand, so obviously from a cosmetic standpoint, people can tell that you don't have hair. And I would think some people wonder if you do have cancer because you don't have hair, mm-hmm. and they think maybe you've had chemotherapy. But for people who don't understand how it affects people, I'm sure you're going to mention something related to self-esteem because of the cosmetic
sure.
changes. But are there health-related issues to having alopecia also?
Well, it is an autoimmune condition, so, you know, it's a chronic condition as well. So a lot of times other autoimmune conditions may be intertwined with folks who have alopecia. In Ava's case, I believe, and in my daughter's case, that's alopecia is the only form of that they have. But it is a chronic condition. It does affect, we always say it's not life-threatening, but it's life-altering.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, a lot of times, a lot of the issues with it can be psychological and so.
Can it ever be reversed?
Well, your hair can grow back, but a lot of times people who've had it for a long, they can come and it can go, which is why this is really an odd kind of disease, and it makes it really hard to figure out what works because you don't know if any of the, you know, if what you're trying to treat it with is actually the disease kind of going into remission on its
yeah.
own, or whether or not what you're doing is working. So, but typically if you have AU, which is universalis, the chances of your hair growing back are a little bit or less. Yeah.
I love those conference pictures mm-hmm. where people were joining people who looked just like them and seeing the beautiful faces on the kids and young adults who are there and some adults as well. Do most people, do you find, who have alopecia, do they wear a wig or not wear a wig?
Well, some people wear wigs, some people don't wear wigs, but I mean, like, it's their decision. I mean, they can wear a wig if they want to.
Do you wear a wig sometimes, or do you usually opt for this beautiful style with the headband kind of thing?
Well, sometimes, like, I like to wear wigs just for, like, for fun or something, but, I mean, sometimes I wear them in school, but not really often.
What color wig do you choose?
I actually was looking at blondes, and it, like...
Did you have more fun?
Well, I like the brown. I have, like...
Thank you.
I have, like, two hat wigs that are brown, and that, like, the same color, and then I have one that's, like, full without a hat, and it has a... and it's the brown color.
Good I want to see you in both.
Yeah.
I want you to switch it up and
we'll
see which
compare.
Way you have more fun.
I love it. Now, your daughter is 16 now, right?
Yeah.
Kaya's 16. How's she doing?
She's doing pretty good. She's a junior this year. She'll actually be 17 in like 2 months.
Wow.
You know, Kaya does at this point stage in life choose to wear a wig, you know? So
yep.
like Ava said, you can kind of, people go back and forth, you know,
yeah.
depending
yeah.
on where you're at in life and where you're at in your journey with this condition.
So talk a little bit about this event coming up. It's this weekend. It's Rock for Locks. It's Morgan's mm-hmm. Ride. What's going to be happening and who can come out and support this cause?
Well, everybody can come out. And if they can't make it, they can bid online on the website. We already have probably about 100 items up for bid. But, the ride's in the morning. So it takes off from the house of Harley-Davidson. It's about a 2.5 hour ride. And then
when it's motorized bikes.
Motorcycles. Mm-hmm. Yep. And when it returns, we'll have two live bands. We have a kids area with face painting, and what else do we have, Abel?
I think you can play kids games.
Someone's gonna be doing caricatures. We also collect hair donations from VC Capelli Salon. So if someone's looking to donate their hair, which will go to Children with Hair Loss to create wigs for kids that do choose to wear them, they can come out and do that too, and they can get their hair cut. We'll take care of sending it in, get styled up.
So cool.
But so there's live music, great food.
I love that you say church festival style gambling games. It's the best description I've ever heard.
Exactly.
It's awesome. So it's going on this Saturday. It's September 7th. 8 o'clock is registration. 10 o'clock, kickstands up. The ride begins. House of Harley-Davidson. You can go to greatermkealopecia.com to learn more. And again, that bidding is online now. It goes, the bidding's through 5:30, but the event is from 1 to 6 o'clock. So bid online now at that same website, greatermkealopecia.com. There's really cool stuff for you to bid on. So make sure you check that out and support the cause, the research, and eventually a cure.
Thanks and for Rocks being here, Relax, you guys. Too. Great to see both of you.
Yeah, you look great.
Thank you
to your school.
So much.
Happy fifth grade.
Bye to your class. All right, now you got to get back and study hard.
Yep.
All right, I know.
A's,
I know.
All A's, girlfriend.
I do like my teacher and all my classes.
Yeah, I'm glad you said that.
But I just want to be a TV star.
Oh, that's
I think so, you already are, my friend.
You're on your way, for sure. It's great to see you, hon. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks for being here.
Appreciate it.